Vulpecula, which is Latin for fox, is a modern-day constellation that can be challenging to find even in the darkest skies. Its stars are of 4th, 5th, and 6th magnitudes, so in order to see this constellation, skies free of light pollution are preferred. But even though this star pattern is faint, it's really easy to find it using the summer triangle. Once you locate the summer triangle, find where Cygnus is, right here. And from there, you want to find the head of the swan. Find the next brightest star, and this is Answer, the brightest star of Vulpecula, which is right here. That's that star pattern there. So there you're going to find the two-star pattern, and the borders of this constellation expand a little bit beyond its pattern. So in this video, we will explore the Little Fox constellation, how to find it, and unique celestial objects within its borders. Welcome to Learn the Sky. My name is Janine, and I'll be your guide as we explore the night sky together, one constellation at a time. Let's get a broad overview of Vulpecula, the Little Fox. It is a modern-day constellation that was first named by Polish astronomer Johann Hevelius in 1684. The name Vulpecula is Latin for Little Fox, and it's the 55th largest constellation, so it's not a very big one. It's also very faint. All the stars are between 4th and 5th, even 6th magnitudes, so you really need dark skies to see this constellation. What it's known for is the Dumbbell Nebula within its boundaries, as well as the Coat Hanger Asterism, which is a new find for me, and I'm fascinated by it because it's so easy to find in the sky. So when can you see it? It's best seen in the northern and southern hemispheres in this range of latitudes, and it can be seen in the summer months. But I find I can also see it in the autumn months because it gets darker earlier, so you're still seeing a little bit of the summer sky. The best way to find it is to use that summer asterism triangle to find Cygnus, which I'm circling right here. From there, you find the head of the swan. The star is called Albireo. I've got a whole video on it. It's one of my favorite stars. And there you want to find the next nearest brightest star, and this is the constellation Vulpecula. But here is some of the boundaries of the constellation, which we'll explore later in this video. So it's really between Cygnus and Sagitta, the arrow, which, do I have it pointed out? There it is. So here you have Cygnus, here you have Sagitta, this is Lyra right here, down here is Aquila, and then this is Vulpecula. So within this boundaries, there's some really cool things to find. And there again is that coat hanger asterism, which we'll talk about a little bit later in the video. Before we get some practice with how to find Vulpecula in the sky, let's touch quickly on its origin. It is a modern-day constellation that was named by Johann Hevelius. He was a Polish astronomer who also worked closely with his wife, Elisabeth Koopman Hevelius. She's considered to be the first female astronomer, and she really helped him catalog many of the things that he saw in the sky, including 10 new constellations, 7 which are used today. He's considered to be the founder of lunar topography. He spent over 4 years mapping the moon. He was patronage of 4 kings of Poland. He observed sunspots, discovered comets, and of course, that close relationship with his wife allowed him to discover more. And the constellations that were named by Hevelius are still recognized by the IAU, or the International Astronomical Union. These are the 7 that are still used today, while these 3 are obsolete. Now let's review the pattern that Vulpecula makes across the sky. It is represented as a fox, and it's known as a seasonal constellation, so it's best seen in the summer months in the northern hemisphere. You want to look for Cygnus and Sagitta, and Vulpecula is in between those two constellations. The best way that I find it is right here, using Albireo, which is the head of the swan, and then looking for this very faint star nearby. You definitely need dark skies to see this constellation, and there are a few celestial objects that we can view inside the borders. So let's get some practice how to find it. This is the first picture I showed you. This gives you a good view of quite a few constellations positions in the summer sky. First, you want to locate the summer triangle. Those are the three brightest stars that make this pattern in the summer sky. And then you want to find the other constellations. So Lyra has the brightest star with Vega, and then go ahead and find Cygnus. The tail of the swan is Deneb, and that's the brightest star of that pattern. But so you want to go to the head of the constellation, the head of the swan, and right there is where you will find Vulpecula. It's very challenging to find unless you have dark skies, so you really have to seek those out if you're going to find it. And of course, my new obsession is the coat hanger asterism. Now that I know what this is, I'm like seeing it in all my pictures. And if we were to zoom in on this area a little bit, this is what this star pattern looks like. You can see it does look like a coat hanger, and it was named after an American astronomer. That's where it got its name, Brocky's cluster. I hope I'm saying that properly. But really, Al-Sufi was the first one that recorded it back in 934, I believe. And he was a Persian astronomer that recorded many things in the sky at the time, constellations, stories that go along with them. So this is a really cool star pattern to see. It's mostly known in the modern times as the coat hanger asterism. So let's get another vantage point of Vulpecula. Well, sort of. At least I can show you other ways how to find them. So here we're actually looking at Aquila, and all my other pictures so far kind of have Aquila cut out. But you can point out some other constellations. This is Scutum right here. I've got a video coming up on this eventually. Still working on it. And then here we have Delphinus, and here is Sagitta. Can you find the coat hanger asterism? It's right there. And then this right here, that is where the alpha star of Vulpecula is. So just another way to help you find it by using Aquila and Sagitta. And if we were to name everything in here, just to help us out. So we're not really seeing the full constellation of Vulpecula, but at least you can see one of the stars there. Let's go ahead and get some more practice. Here, can you find the summer triangle? Right there, that's where the summer triangle is. And then you want to find Cygnus. I can easily find it. It makes that big cross across the sky. Here is the head of the swan. So right there is where Vulpecula will be. So there's where Aquila is in reference. All the constellations that are part of the summer triangle. There's Scutum. There's Sagitta. Oops, I went too far. And there's Vulpecula. And again, coat hanger asterism right there. My eye is instantly drawn to it. I love it. We'll try one more picture. This is a really large, wide view of the summer sky. So here on the left side, you should see the summer triangle. From there, that's where Vulpecula is. So I like this picture because it kind of gives you an idea of, like, it kind of leans more towards the Aquila side of, or, you know, vertex of the triangle. I don't know if I'm saying that right. The angle of the triangle. I'm not a strong math person, but here we go. This is where Aquila is. There's all the constellations of the summer triangle. There's Sagitta, Delphinus, Scutum, and then Vulpecula is right here. But keep in mind, this area is also classified or within the borders of Vulpecula as well. I can still see that coat hanger asterism right there. And if we were to name some of the other things, we have Ophiuchus, Scorpius, Sagittarius, Corona Australis. Ophiuchus is holding the serpent. And here is everything we talked about so far. So I hope these are helpful for you in order to find Vulpecula. It's not very bright, but if you know the surrounding constellations, which are pretty easy to find, and if you have dark skies, you should be able to find this one. In the last portion of this video, we're going to take a look at some of the celestial objects that are located in the constellation of Vulpecula, the Little Fox. So we're going to focus on these two areas, and this one down here is known as M27, the Messier 27, called the Dumbbell Nebula, and then this is a small star cluster known as NGC 680. 885. So let's dive in. Messier 27, as I said earlier, is known as the Dumbbell Nebula, and it's a very popular observing target for amateur astronomers, especially using telescopes. You could see it with a pair of binoculars as well. Its magnitude is 7.5, and it's pretty easy to find with magnification. And this was really the first type of nebula like this to be discovered by Charles Messier in 1764. I have a different viewpoint of it here for you. This is just using a different filter, and it allows you to see different structures. And some of this color here, yes, it is artificial color, but it helps us see the structure of what we're looking at. And this right here is a white dwarf star in the center of it. A white dwarf star is like the leftover core of a dying star, and it's no longer fusing any gases together, but it's rather shedding its outer layers. So you can kind of see it looks like a bubble here, and then matter is ejected out kind of from the core. And there's another planetary nebula I'm going to show you that's within this constellation, and you can see that the structure is very similar. And this is what will happen to our own sun. It will expand into a red giant star, and then it will no longer fuse its gases and start to eject its outer layers. Here's another viewpoint from the Spitzer telescope, and this is an infrared image, and you can just see that's, you're kind of looking at the heat, and you can see the different structures here. It's kind of emanating from the core, and it's almost symmetrical the way it looks. And if we would compare visible light with infrared, you can see those similar cone-like structures that are emanating, you know, the point being from the center and out. I've got one more shot for you. I really love this picture, probably because all the stars in it are so beautiful. But right there, that's the Dumbbell Nebula. So I hope you're able to find it in the future. The other object of interest is an open star cluster located in this region of Vulpecula. It's estimated to be 1,950 light years away, and it's an open star cluster, which means it doesn't have a definitive shape, unlike globular star clusters. I do have a video on the different types of the star clusters, so if you want to learn more, you can go see that video. And then one other object that you were not able to see because it's too faint, but it's still there, and I wanted to share it with you because this image looks so gorgeous. And this again is another planetary nebula. Its name is HEN 2-437. I'm not sure if you say hen 2-437, but it's a fairly recent discovery in 1946, and this was taken by the Hubble telescope. So you're not going to be able to see this in the sky, but just know that it's there when you're looking towards the direction of Vulpecula. And again, this right here is where that white dwarf star would be, leftover core of a star, and it's just emanating all this energy out from the core. Again, it has that symmetrical look, and it's gorgeous to look at, so I had to share it with you. So we've come to the end of our video about Vulpecula. I hope this was helpful for you in order to help you find it in the sky. However, I think many of us will be challenged to find it. We have that light pollution problem, where there is just so much artificial light out there that we're not able to see the natural light of the sky. So if you're going to try to find this, you have to seek out dark skies. It can be seen in both the northern and southern hemispheres, and it's mostly seen in the summer. However, it's autumn as I'm filming this, and I can still see it because it gets darker earlier, and I'm still seeing the summer sky before it gets too late at night. And the best way to find it is using the summer triangle. Find Cygnus, find the head of the swan, and then look for that two-star pattern nearby. It is in between Cygnus and Sagitta, and oh, Delphinus makes its little appearance down here, as well as Lyra. It's known for the Dumbbell Nebula, as well as the Coat Hanger Nebula. That's not nebula, it should be asterism. I've never corrected a video as I film it, but there's a first for everything. There we go. I have to be correct, don't I? But the Coat Hanger asterism is right there. And I don't know if I mentioned this earlier in the video, but there's debate as to whether this really is a star cluster. I think the latest data out on this little region right here is that they just happen to be positioned like that in the sky. I'll bring my video up. But yeah, that's what's really interesting. It's not really considered to be a star cluster anymore, rather that they're just a chance alignment of these stars. But, you know, that was published back in 1997. So however, that information could change. So remember, anytime you go outside, it takes patience and practice. So be consistent with it. Go outside, bring a friend with you, and whether it's a human or a pet, and just enjoy that time in nature. And as always, keep looking up.